Dr. Centeno, and I'd like to go over should you get meniscus surgery. Now, I love taking things from my daily practice and incorporating them into these videos, so I'm going to do that today. So while this is a common surgery for meniscus tears, all of the high-level evidence to date shows that this procedure is ineffective. Now, these are just some New York Times articles here. However, there are many other high-level research studies that show this doesn't work. Now, why would that be the case? This is such a common surgery, you would think we knew this would work, but the research shows it doesn't. And one of the many answers is actually shown with a cork in a bottle. So you can see up top there that if you've got a cork nicely seated in the bottle, the pressure in the bottle won't push out the cork. But if you've got a short cork or a cork that's not seated well in that bottle, it's going to push out that cork. And the same thing happens with meniscectomy. Before meniscectomy, the patient's got a little tear in their meniscus, which I'll draw in here. And then the surgeon goes in and whacks out a piece. And after meniscectomy, because that anchor is lost, the meniscus tends to spit out the joint, and that patient gets to be miserable. So here's an example. You can see the meniscus here. I'll outline it. It's this triangle, and it's sitting inside the joint. I've drawn that yellow line. Now, this is just 8 months after this guy's meniscus surgery, and this guy's been miserable ever since, and his meniscus has pushed out. It's now spit out of the joint, and it's no longer protecting that joint. So now this is a stress ultrasound testing of the joint. And I've outlined the meniscus there on his normal side and his surgery side. So this is the same exact patient. So on the normal side, when I stress that joint, not much changes with regard to that position of the meniscus. But when I stress his surgery side, you can see his joint gapes open and his meniscus gets sucked into the joint. So that side is now clearly unstable, which is a bad thing for his knee. Stop. Do not get meniscus surgery. There are other options. A precise ultrasound-guided injection of your own platelets or stem cells may help the problem and retain the maximum amount of meniscus tissue. However, be cautious that there are scams out there and there are scam artists. There are folks offering seminars with high pressure to sign up where they're blindly injecting dead amniotic or cord tissues that don't have viable stem cells despite the fact that they will swear in a stack of Bibles this is a stem cell therapy. So be careful out there. If you want more reliable information, see regenix.com and have a great day.